नेक्स्ट टॉपिक एनर्जी ऑफ एन ऑर्बिटिंग सैटेलाइट। वी नो ऑर्बिटल वेलोसिटी ऑफ सैटेलाइट V naught is equal to square root of G capital M E by R E plus H. So here kinetic energy of satellite is equal to half M V naught square. So that is half M. Here V naught square is what? So that is G M E by R E plus H. From this kinetic energy is G capital M E, so here small m by 2 R E plus H. We know gravitational potential energy, so that is potential energy U of R is equal, so here minus G capital M E small m by R E plus H. So here total energy E is equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. So here potential energy is minus G capital M E small m by R E plus H plus G capital M E small m by 2 R E plus H. So here it is minus 1. Here it is 1 by 2. Minus 1, 1 by 2 is minus 1 by 2. So total energy is equal to what? Minus G M E M by 2 into R E plus H. So total energy of satellite is how much? That is E is equal to minus G M E M by 2 R E plus H. So here potential energy is a negative and total energy is also negative. So here we can write potential energy is equal minus G M E M by R E plus H. So here I am multiplying dividing with 2. So from this we can write 2 into minus G M E small m by 2 into R E plus H. So here it is total energy. So we can write 2 into total energy. So potential energy is a 2 times of total energy. And here potential energy and total energy is a negative value. If total energy is a positive or zero, the object escape to infinite. But satellites are at finite height, so E must be negative. Next topic, geostationary satellites. Satellites in a circular orbit around the Earth in the equatorial plane with time period t is equal 24 hours are called geostationary satellite. Here it is a Earth. Earth rotate its own axis. So here it is a equatorial plane. Here satellites revolve in circular orbit around the Earth in an equatorial plane with time period t is equal to 24 hours. So that satellites are known as geostationary satellites. So here time period of satellite and Earth have same, that is 24 hours. So here satellite appear stationary from a point on Earth. So this is known as geostationary satellites. According to Kepler's third law or law of periods, we know t square is equal 4 pi square by gme re plus h whole cube. So from this re plus h whole cube is equal, we can write t square gme by 4 pi square. Take cube root on both sides. So we can get re plus h is equal t square gme by 4 pi square whole to the power of 1 by 3. So here time period of geostationary satellite t is equal 24 hours. So from this equation, so here radius of Earth is known, universal gravitational constant g is known, mass of the Earth is known value, and if we substitute t is equal 24 hours, we can get height of the geostationary satellites. So that is 35,800 kilometer. The height of the geostationary satellite is 35,800 kilometer. Geostationary satellites appear stationary from a point on Earth surface. So here these satellites are used in telecommunications. In India, INSAT group of satellites are used for telecommunications. So here INSAT means Indian National Satellites. Next topic is polar satellites. These are low altitude satellites. So that is the height of the satellite is very less. So that is nearly 500 kilometer to 800 kilometer. And the time period of polar satellite is 100 minutes. So it cross any altitude many times in a day. The polar satellites revolve around the poles of the Earth in north to south direction. So here Earth rotate its own axis. Here it is north south direction. So here polar satellites revolve around the poles of Earth in north to south direction. A camera fixed on a satellite can view a small strip on the Earth in one orbit. The adjacent strip are viewed in next orbit. The whole Earth can view strip by strip during the entire day. These satellites are used for remote sensing. Meteorology. And environmental studies of the Earth. Next topic is weightlessness. When an object is in free fall, it is weightless. And this phenomenon is called weightlessness. We know weight is gravitational force of attraction. If there is no gravitational force of attraction, it is weightless. One end of the spring balance is attached to ceiling and another end is here we have to take objects. Here when object is placed, it show some weight. So that is equal to gravitational force of attraction. So that is called mg. This is equal to spring force. So that is fs. So when spring balance is freely falling, here spring force is zero. So here weight is zero. So here object is at weightlessness.